Okay, so good morning guys. So for today's session, we will continue our topic, which is this is part 3, because part 1 and part 2 is settled. So the chapter, the subtopic left is response of plants to stimuli. So we will observe how plants will react to stimuli, and then we have a stereoscopic and monocular vision for different organisms, which is animal. And then we have stereophonic hearing and other senses in animal. So let's check the book. Okay, so this is your sense process skill book. So this one is page 22. Okay, so you may refer to your sense process skill book, page 22. So number one, you have to match and the type of tropism and response to their importance. So we have phototropism, which is phototropism. The photo means, in science, photo means light. So macam kalau kita ada photography. So without photo, kita tak boleh nak dapat. We cannot take the picture at all. Sebab kalau waktu siang ada cahaya, waktu malam, okay, kalau let's say waktu malam, we need a flash to make sure dia punya picture tadi clear lah kalau kita nak snap picture. So kalau tak ada photo, means without light, tak akan berlaku benda ni. Phototropism, phototropism respond to the light. Kalau photosynthesis, because of the light, okay, waktu siang baru boleh buat photosynthesis. Waktu malam tak buat photosynthesis because without photo. Okay, so in science, photo means respond. Photo means light. So tropism means respond. Respond to the light. Okay. So the stimuli is light. The type of tropism is phototropism, and the importance is to enable plants to obtain light for photosynthesis. So that's why dia akan pergi cari light tu. And then we have a positive and negative. Nanti kita akan tengok lah. And then we have second stimuli is gravity. So gravity is geotropism. So we have four types of tropism and then one nastic movement. Okay, every plant we have phototropism, geotropism, hydrotropism and thigmotropism. Instead only for tropism. Yeah. So geo means for gravity. So what is importance? Importance of geotropism is to support the plant and enable them to obtain water and mineral salt. Okay. So we have gravity, dia bergerak ke bawah kalau kita baling barang, so that dia akan bergerak ke bawah. So nanti kita akan tengok positive and negative geotropism. Because we have shoot and root. So shoot macam daun dia lah, pucuk dia. Root dia punya akar ke arah mana. And then we have water. Okay, the stimuli of water. And then the type of tropism, hydro. So apa-apa saja hydro, itu ada berkenaan dengan air. Let's say hydroelectric, hydroponic. Okay, so anything about hydro means water. Okay, in science. So the importance is enable plants to obtain water and mineral salts. Sebab bahagian mana yang buat, yang cari water ni? Bahagian akar dia lah, the roots. And then we have thigmotropism. So thigmotropism means touch. Okay. Why thigmotropism is important? To give support to the plant. Sebab sometimes dia nak cari matahari tu terlalu tinggi. So kalau dia duduk dekat bawah, tak boleh nak buat apa, dia perlu panjat pokok yang lain ataupun dia akan panjat tiang-tiang ataupun pagar, so that dia akan enables dia boleh melakukan phototropism tadilah. So that thigmotropism, dia boleh support plants tu tadi. Okay, dia lebih kukuh lah. And then the last one, we have nastic movement. So nastic movement as a defense. So special case for not semua plants tu tadi ada nastic movement. Some of the plants saja yang akan ada nastic movement. Okay. So identify the type of tropism, which positive or negative. Okay, number one, should grow towards light. So of course phototropism positive, because should yang akan buat kerja tu, dia akan positif kepada foto. Okay, pucuk tu tadi, daun dia yang akan pergi kepada foto. So that mana yang pergi ke arah situ means that adalah positif. Okay, and then we have roots grow away from light. Sebab roots tak buat kerja tu. Okay, so light, apa-apa light mesti foto, phototropism. Okay, tapi kita bagi tahu yang ni away, away dia tak buat, dia tak cari light tu tadi. So that kita bagi tahu dia sebagai negatif. So mana yang positif, mana yang negatif. So focus on positive part only. Kalau dia tanya yang negative part, means that apa yang berlawan dengan dia. Kalau tadi should nak cari light, so that positive tropism. Root, dia tak cari light, so that dia akan mengalami negative phototropism. And then the roots grow towards gravity. Dia ke arah gravity, ke arah bawah. So that yang ke arah bawah, yang mencari air itulah roots. Okay, roots memang ke arah bawah. Dia akan follow the gravity. So that apa yang akan berlaku adalah positive geotropism. Then should grow away from gravity. Sebab gravity ke arah bawah, tapi should dia akan naik ke arah atas. So that bila dia naik ke arah atas, means that dia adalah negative geotropism. Okay, and then we have roots grow towards water. So positive hydro. Dia nak cari air, dia suka pada air, so that positive hydro. Should away from water, so itu adalah negative hydrotropism. Ni you kena mention penuh, type dengan tepat. And then we have tendrils coils around twigs. So that dia paut, dia lilit ranting kayu. Sebab apa? Sebab nak support dia tu tadi. And then bila boleh support dia tu tadi, dia boleh naik dekat tempat tinggi dan dia boleh mengalami positive phototropism. So that kalau yang ni kita tak ada positive or negative, so that thigmotropism only. Then the leaf of the mimosa plant close immediately upon touching. So kita sentuh saja dia tu tutup, ada gerakan nastic. So itu kita bagi tahu nastic movement. Okay, kita ada macam pokok yang ada orang kata dia makan lalat, makan ulat tu. Okay, itu dia tak makan pun, sebab we know plants dia buat makanan dia sendiri. Okay, because dia ni tadi adalah producer. So that kita tak boleh bagi tahu periuk kera tu tadi, pokok periuk kera tu dia makan lalat, makan apa semua, itu tak tepat. So actually dia nastic movement. Sebab apa? Sebab plants dia buat makanan dia sendiri, ya. Okay, then okay, settle this part. Saya tunjukkan sikit video. So first, positive phototropism. Timelapse yang lain. Negative gravity phototropism means that geotropism lah. Kalau kita letakkan sengit macam ni, okay, so dia actually pun still akan naik ke arah atas, because dia ni tadi negative geotropism, akar dia akan pergi ke bawah, okay, tapi dia akan naik ke atas macam tu lah, because dia ada negative geotropism, memang shoot akan naik ke arah atas, okay. And then lagi satu, dia mengalami positive phototropism, that's why dia naik atas juga. Dia nanti ada, kalau ada soalan yang lagi tepat, nanti saya akan tunjukkan. Dan geotropism, okay, let's say for this one. So this is a simulation only. So this shoot will experience positive phototropism. Dia akan naik atas. And as well, dia akan mengalami negative geotropism. Dia akan naik ke arah atas. Yang sini akan mengalami positive hydrotropism, nak cari air ke arah bawah, dan juga positive geotropism. So that akan turun ke arah bawah. Okay. Ini daripada awal lah, how the seed will germinate. So dia akan keluarkan roots and shoot. Shoot akan naik atas, roots akan naik bawah. Tapi bukan geotropism sajalah, kita akan tengok pada hydrotropism juga. Ada satu soalan, ni tadi dia tak tunjukkan. Let's say, okay, let's say kita letakkan light dekat bawah sini, okay. So light dekat bawah, and then there should be ada positive phototropism. Should be dia nak mencari sini, tapi sebelum dia cari light tu, tadi dia dah dapat light kan, dia memang akan naik atas dulu, tapi lepas tu dia akan turun ke bawah. Lama-lama dia akan turun ke bawah. Saya tak jumpa video tu tadi. Saya tak tahu orang tu dah buang ke. Dulu ada video tu. Same goes to this one. Kalau mula-mula dia mesti turun ke bawah, sebab dia mengalami geotropism, positive geotropism. Tapi kalau sumber air berada dekat bahagian atas ini, so that lama-lama nanti dia punya root tu akan pergi naik ke atas. Dia akan lawan pada geotropism tu tadi. Yang ni pun boleh lawan pada negative geotropism. Dia boleh turun bawah sebab kalau ada cahaya dekat bawah ni. Okay, continue. Itu tadi. Oh, sini. Okay, so next subtopic we have stereoscopic and monocular. So what is stereo? What is mono? Mono means one lah. Okay, stereo means surround, dia macam surrounding punya kan, sekeliling. So dia lebih luas. So we have two type of vision, which is stereoscopic vision and monocular vision. So mono dia akan nampak satu saja, and normally mono ni tadi dia adalah prey, mangsa, and normally stereoscopic vision for predator, yang memburu, pemangsa. Okay. So where's the position of the both eyes? So macam kalau kita lah, kita stereoscopic because of kita ni tadi actually the predator. Oh, zaman-zaman dulu kita memburu nak dapatkan makanan. So that's why we need position of both eyes in front of the heads. Kalau macam kambing, rusa dan sebagainya tu, kita tengok dia dekat tepi. Okay, the side of the head. Sebab apa? Ada sebab dia nanti. Sebab dia ni tadi mangsa ataupun prey tu tadi. Okay. So the field of vision for us, okay, stereoscopic vision, dia punya field of vision narrow and overlapping. Why narrow? Okay. Narrow sebab kita nak bagi lebih fokus. Okay. And overlapping means kita ada 3D. That's why dia akan overlap. So for monocular vision, dia punya field of vision ni tadi wide and does not overlap. But dia ni tadi dia nak monitor sekeliling ni tadi, the surrounding, so that dia punya tu lebih wide lah. That's why kita bagi tahu untuk prey, dia ni tadi perlu ada monocular vision. Sebab kalau tak, dia tengah-tengah minum air, tengah makan rumput, tiba-tiba ada predator daripada belakang nak attack dia. That's why dia perlu selamatkan diri dia. So that penglihatan dia pun perlu wide juga. Okay. And then tak perlu overlap lah, sebab dia ni tadi dia tak nak nak terlalu 3D ke apa. Kalau macam kita, kita mesti ada kejapkan nanti fokus. Kan? Kalau macam lens, kita kan dia ada macam autofocus. So that dia ada macam overlapping tu lah. So that kita akan take time. So kalau kita tengok macam ada the predator, anjing kita ke, kucing kita ke, dia before nak attack something tu, dia akan relax, dia akan jaga-jaga dulu. Dia akan take time so that dah confirm boleh lepas, so that boleh attack. Then we have a type of image form because overlapping, 3D lah. Yang ni tadi does not overlap, so that dia 2D only. And estimation of distance, size and depth. Okay. So for stereoscopic vision, it can estimate distance accurately. That's why dia tak akan terus simply daripada jauh terus pergi kejar je, tak. Dia akan rapat dulu, rasa ni boleh estimate, ni boleh lepas ni, so that kita baru boleh kejar dengan tepat, boleh sampai dengan tepat lah. Okay. So yang ni, they cannot estimate distance accurately, so that dia kena jaga-jaga daripada ni. Sometimes kita tengok, kalau dia tak perasan, dia tak tahu pun apa tu dekat dengan dia, the predator dekat dengan dia. So dia boleh kena tangkap juga dan kena makan. Okay. Then type of organism, biasanya humans and most of the predators lah. Human kita ni predator actually. And for monocular, most of the prey, kebanyakan dia. Sebab dia nak selamatkan diri je, that's why dia perlu wide. Okay. And then the importance, this help predators to hunt prey. Sebab kita boleh estimate distance dan kita juga kita boleh fokus. Okay. Yang ni importance for monocular vision is to help prey to detect and escape from the predators. Okay, tu nanti tengok video dalam YouTube. Dalam YouTube dia ada banyak sebenarnya. Okay, next, we have stereoponic hearing and other sense in animal. So that, number one, okay, this situation, we have student A and then one will clap. Okay, and then A need to determine accurately the direction and location of the source of sound with both eyes blindfolded. Jadi, kita buat situation macam ni, teka saja dekat mana. Kalau ada echo lagi susah kita nak detect dekat mana dia punya location yang the sources yang asal tu tadi. Okay. So number one, what is the hearing that uses both ears? So we call it as a stereophonic hearing. Okay, sebab kita ada dua, telinga ada dua, that's why stereo. Okay. Kalau sebelah saja kita susah nak tentukan. Kalau sebelah saja means that mono lah. Okay. Tutup sebelah telinga. So that kita akan lagi susah nak detect dekat mana dia punya location asal dia. And then, what is the advantages of stereophonic hearing? Okay. It enables the direction and location of sound to determine more accurately. Okay. Jadi kita boleh tentukan arah dan juga lokasi yang lebih tepat daripada mana bunyi itu datang. And then, stereophonic hearing helps predator to determine the location of their prey. On the other hand, what is the importance of stereophonic hearing to the prey? So, this one kita kata, tadi kita bagi tahu predator boleh detect dan determine the location prey tu tadi dekat mana. Tapi untuk prey, it will help prey to determine the location of predator and escape from them. So that dua-dua boleh dengar dengan baik. Okay, sama sahaja. Sebab tu telinga kita ada dua and then kita boleh mendengar dengan lebih baik. Then the following are the pest animal with their sensory organs. Circle the correct answer. Okay, so for this one, South African porcupine. So dia ada mustache. Yang ni kita tak adalah garis lateral tak ada dekat sini eh. Ini tak penting pun sebenarnya. And then grasshopper body sense. Sebab ni dia bagi tahu sensory organ. Ini bukan sensory organ. Okay, organ Jacobson ni nanti kita google lah. Tapi benda ni tak berapa penting pun. So ni boleh abaikan lah. Okay, so that kita dah settle that topic. Ini nanti awak cuba buat sendirilah practice pengukuhan ni. Sebab practice pengukuhan biasanya kita akan set mark untuk yang last sekali sebelum kita exam. Alright, itu sahaja. Thank you.